Yo guys, my name is Leon Austria and today's video I'm going to give you guys a tour of my workstation, or as some people may call it, my desk setup. So first, let us begin with my table. The table I'm currently using is a unique piece designed by yours truly. You see guys, in the Philippines, we ain't got no IKEA stores to buy awesome cheap furniture from. So yeah, if you want a table, your only choices are either you go to SM or you just build one yourself. So for this desk setup, I opted for the cheaper option and I just decided to design my own table. So for the frame of the table, I used 1x2-inch steel tubes painted with white enamel, and for the tabletop, I opted to use some scrap mahogany wood floor planks that were left over from a previous project. So for the design of the table, I was going for a modern floaty look. That's why I designed it with a gap in between the table frame and the tabletop to give it the illusion that the tabletop is floating like magic. Also, another thing I love about the steel frame of the table is that I can store secret notebooks and secret pencils underneath it. I just have to attach magnets to pencils and notebooks and boom, magic. I can just stick them under the table like magic. I used magic way too much times in this paragraph. Let's move on. Okay, so what table is complete without a chair? None, unless you're Japanese. Okay, so the chair I'm using is super not interesting. It's just a regular wire mesh chair I got from the department store when it was on sale. So I don't know if a ton of you guys can relate, but me personally, I'm a huge fan of these wire mesh back chairs because your boy is a sweaty dude. So yeah, wire mesh chairs are the way to go if you have hyperactive sweat glands. Anyways, let's move on to the things on top of my desk. Mainly, my monitor setup. So right here, I'm rocking a dual monitor setup. These are the Asus VC239H monitors. So the reason why I bought these monitors is because Asus claims that these are ultra-low blue light monitors, which means that your eyes would be less stressed after long periods of staring at the screen. Also, these are IPS panels, which are the best type of panels when it comes to color reproduction or accuracy and contrast values, and are typically geared towards creative professionals. But the biggest determining factor was the price. These were, at the time when I bought them, one of the cheapest monitors you could get. And you know, you gotta stay frugal, because architects at the start of their career don't really get paid that much. I recommend checking these monitors out because of their price and their performance. So the reason why I got two monitors is because I use this main monitor for AutoCAD or SketchUp, while I have some reference materials open on the side monitor. Above these monitors is a 42-inch Devant TV, which I occasionally use as a third monitor. For the accent lights behind the TV and my monitors, I bought these cheap RGB light strips from Lazada for around 7 bucks for a 3-meter strip. And that is my main display setup. Below these monitors, we have some of my peripherals, which lay on top of this 80x40 leather mouse pad that I found online for around 15 bucks. Which honestly is a great deal and makes my desk setup look super clean and ties in well with the black bezels of my monitor and my peripherals. For the keyboard, I'm using the Corsair K63 wireless mechanical keyboard. I went for this one because I wanted a wireless keyboard that has mechanical key switches and backlights, all of which this keyboard has. I also love that this keyboard is 10 keyless, which means the number pad has been removed from the keyboard, making it more ergonomic since I can place my mouse hand and typing hand closer together in a more natural position. Trust me, if you're an architect that spends 8 to 10 hours a day in front of the computer, ergonomics is a huge factor when deciding what peripherals to pursue or to buy. Which brings me to the next item on our table, the mice. So depending on the programs I use, I mainly cycle between three of my favorite mice. When I'm doing architectural works, I use the Logitech G602 wireless gaming mouse. I found the additional programmable buttons along the side super useful for remapping my go-to AutoCAD or SketchUp commands. For editing video, I use the Logitech MX Master just cause it has this side scroll wheel that comes in super handy when scrubbing through the Adobe Premiere Pro timeline. So one of the first things I usually do when I get a new mouse is I remap the scroll wheel click button to another button on my mouse, cause in AutoCAD and SketchUp, the scroll click is one of the most used buttons. So for AutoCAD, it is used for panning, and for SketchUp, it is used for orbit or rotating the view. And let me tell you guys, I broke so many mice and one of the first things to break is the scroll click. Anyways, let's move on to the last mouse on my list, the Logitech G Pro Wireless. So this tiny mouse right here is what I use whenever I play games. This is a super lightweight mouse that features Logitech's Hero sensor, which is the most accurate sensor Logitech has released to date. Perfect for FPS games like Counter-Strike, Apex Legends, and PUBG. But, you know, I just use it for Sims and Minecraft. Sometimes SketchUp. You gotta be extra accurate when doing SketchUp. So if you guys are wondering why I need three mice, it's because I got a problem, guys. I got a problem and I can't stop buying mice. God dang it, Leon. Moving on. Now, one of my favorite pieces of tech that I just recently obtained are these Samsung Galaxy Buds. These are my daily drivers for when I'm listening to music while I'm making plans in AutoCAD, and I also use this whenever I edit my videos. What I love about these are that they are wireless Bluetooth earbuds, which means I don't have to worry about standing up and accidentally pulling my PC into the shadow realm, which actually happened once, and now the front audio port of my PC is broken. Darn you, wireless! Goddamn. Anywho, let us move on to the thing you've all been waiting for me to discuss. Let's talk about my PC setup. For my PC case, I'm rocking the OG minimalist PC case, the Fractal Design Define R4, with an acrylic side panel, perfect for viewing my sexy PC components. For the processor, I have the Intel i7-4770K running at 3.9 GHz, coupled with 16 GB of DDR4 RAM. Now, all of these are real old parts, probably around 6 years old, but these are still decent enough to handle heavy 3D models and demanding V-Ray render tasks. To support my old PC parts, I went and bought a new RTX 2070 graphics card, which can comfortably play any AAA game title with high to ultra graphics settings, and it crushes any 3D modeling program I throw at it. For storage, I just use SSDs for my OS and main programs that I use on the daily, like AutoCAD, SketchUp, Photoshop, and Revit. As for file storage and archives, I just used HDDs because they are a lot cheaper. So if you guys want an in-depth guide to computer parts that you need to buy for architectural programs, I made a video right here. You guys could check out the link up here, or you guys could check the link in the description below. And with that, I guess I am going to end the video right here. So if you guys like this video, don't forget to like, leave a comment, and subscribe down below for more architectural videos like this. Maybe I'll make a room tour soon. We don't know. You wouldn't know if you didn't subscribe, so yeah, hit that sub button. Also, if you would be so kind to click that notification bell down below, it would make me super happy. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. I will see you guys on my next video. Flying peace!